Hello, I'm Echo from house.com, and of course this is a Burton Process Flying V snowboard. It's a park deck designed for intermediate to advanced level snowboarders. You've probably seen this board around a lot. This is Mark McMorris's kind of pro model board of choice. Of course you can buy it at thehouse.com by clicking on the link below. This is a really good deck, and it kind of resembles the graphic of the custom, which is kind of unique because they're definitely different boards. This one is very park specific, and it comes actually in three different profile shapes. The Flying V, like this one, the off axis, and of course the classic camber. I like the Flying V one. It's gonna be a little bit looser. The profile shape is actually reverse camber in between the feet, so it actually teeter-totters just slightly, and then camber underneath each foot, and then a little bit of rocker on the nose and tail to lift up those contact points. The reason that I like Flying V is because classic camber, you kind of really have to watch out and like really pay attention to your riding. With the Flying V, it's a little less catchy and kind of just like loose feeling, and you'll probably be a little bit more creative in your riding because you won't be afraid of like catching your edge with the classic camber profile shape. And that's why I like Flying V, especially in the process. Now it does feature a true twin shaping. The nose and tail are the exact same shape. When you ride it this way, it's gonna ride the same as it does it this way. And it features a centered style stance and a twin flex of a four. It's gonna be a little bit softer than your average deck. And another cool thing about the process is it holds up to the test of time, and that's why they gave it a 3-year warranty. So hopefully nothing will happen within those 3 years. Inside the process, Flying V is a Superfly 2 dual zone EGD wood core. I know that sounds like a lot of crazy stuff. Anyway, there's lots of different laminates of wood inside the core, but the core has been profiled with something called squeeze box core profiling. That means on the medial and lateral sides of where the bindings rest in the channel pack, the core is going to be just a little bit thicker, so the board has a better energy transfer from your body directly to the snow. The base is ultra fast. This is a sintered style base. It absorbs tons of wax, so make sure to keep it waxed up throughout the season. And that wood core actually has a Tri-X fiberglass as well. So even though it has like a little bit looser of a profile shape with the Flying V, the Tri-X glass gives the board a little bit of extra pop. And then of course it's going to be that 360 wrap standard steel edge and frostbite edges, which is cool because there's protruding edges where the bindings are that help to grip on really firm snow. So there's a lot of stuff going on with this deck. It's a true twin board. It does actually feature a little bit of scoop on the nose and tail as well to make it even more catch free. Is it a park board? Of course. Can you ride it all over the mountain? Yes, you can. You could, you know, maybe even consider this all mountain freestyle, but for the most part, you'll see most people riding it in the parks. This is the process. You can check it out by clicking on the link below in the description. Thanks for watching. Leave a comment or a question. Let us know if you've ridden this board before, and remember to subscribe to the channel. We just passed 26,000 subscribers. That's a huge deal, especially to me. So thanks for being part of that. And of course, thanks for being awesome. Peace. Yeah.